Hey everybody, welcome back. Grognard's Corner, Devin here, stepping into turn 3 of our playthrough of the Scheldt campaign. Scheldt, something like that. I'm sure depending on which dialect you want to go with, it's either Scheldt or Scheldt. So, we're stepping into the Allies turn 3. So let's take a look at what admin counters we have to play with. And what have we got here? We got 3 G1s, two G3s, and 2 G4s. All right, just because my OCD has kind of been screaming at me lately, and as we all know, got to feed the OCD beast. We're going to take one of the G1 counters, and we're going to take this third Canadian, or third Polish something or other. What exactly is that? I don't even know what that icon is. Is that motorized? Oh, it is motorized. Okay. Let's take this Polish motorized infantry and absorb them into the first Polish task force. As we see on our sheet way up there. Go ahead and stick them in there so they'll be part of the task force. Because, like I said, my OCD doesn't let me get away too long with it. It's Polish. It's supposed to be with the rest of the task force. And also, we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to spend a G1 admin counter and absorb the 6th Infantry into the 2nd Canadian. I believe that's the 2nd Canadian. Yep. Ahead and put them up here as well. Now we have another G1 counter, and I believe, what did I want to do with that? Oh yeah, we've got a, let's see, do we want to do with that -2 or that -2? Oh, you know what, let's try to get the Poles some of their armor back. So let's burn the G1 command counter for reinforcements. 6, that's going to be 3 points back, so they get there, they're all the way back up to normal. Alright, now we got some G3s and some G4s. What are we going to do? Well, first of all, I think one of the G3s, what we're going to do is just spend G3 to do a movement over here, because I want to keep the pace up and keep the pressure up on the Germans. Managed to break through that first defensive line relatively easy, so we don't want to let the Germans get any bright ideas. So we'll push the 3rd Canadian up there, and then I think what we want to do with the other G3 is initiate an attack with the 49th against the 719th. Right here. So let's just go ahead and throw a battle counter down there. And you know what? We're going to take one of the G4 logistics markers to call in some air support. So that's going to give us 3 extra dice right off the top. So let's go ahead and set those there. Let's find the 49th. The 49th has got a lot of stuff in it. I have a feeling they're going to be hurting that German unit very, very badly. So we've got 1 armored and 3 infantry brigades and a couple of artillery units supporting in the backfield. So 719th, so hard to read the task force counters. Yep. The Germans ain't got much anything. And they don't have any artillery in range. They've got a G4 logistics marker that they can burn, but there's no artillery in range. So, looks like they're just going to be suffering in silence there. And the 719th, they're in open terrain, so there's not going to be any defensive resistance that they get from terrain. They're going to get 3, 4, 5, 6 dice. So 6 dice. Not that you can really see it that well in the dice cup. And we got three. Oop, that actually was a five. So we got 3 5s, so we inflicted 3 hits. You know, it's I'm running out of one hits again, so one, a two, and we'll put a dice on him for a three hits. Now, let's see. Germans, or the British Canadians, allies, 6, 15, 20, 27, 20, 30 dice. Oh my God. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, I do have, I got 15 dice here. We're going to be rolling them twice. Yeah, buckets of dice, boys and girls. Buckets of dice. Where is that good? Ow, I'm just going to set her off to the side. I have to trust my word on it. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Go ahead and show that real quick. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hits so far. So let's just go ahead and put a 6 up there to mark how many hits we've taken. Now, the combat chart has got a sliding scale. Actually, it's not really a sliding scale. It's just a flat-out scale that shows you. See that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 all the way up? That's to mark the number of hits. But since we're not really using that, are we? All right, next batch. We're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yep, 6 more hits. So 12 hits, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, half the hits can be converted into hexes that they retreat, which would be 6, but they'd still have 6 hits they have to take. Actually, they can't because, yeah, it's, yeah, they're dead. They are completely kaputsky. All right. So what that means is, since we're having the battle here, 7/19th, we'll go back to the order of battle, and I could reform them with ad hoc units later. And the 49th will get to advance into there. Okay. And then all the British units, we'll go back on the task force chart. And that means I have a G4 logistics left, which I can use. Not for really much. I think I can do a tactical move with it. Let's see, what else can I do with the G4s? Planning on doing 2 attacks, but that kind of petered out. Yeah, strategic movement. Who do I have? Oh, well, no, see, that's not going to really do me any good. Because strategic movement, I can't move adjacent to. So, you know, I could move the 1st Canadian to there. Or, yeah, he's not going to be able to move anywhere. And the guys over here, they're, well, I could move one of these units. Well, that's something. I could move this infantry brigade. You know what? Yeah, let's do that. Let's go ahead and spin that G4 to strategic move them and move them into defensive positions in there. All right, now let's see what we want to do next turn. All right, next turn we definitely want to get a strike in there. We want to attack there, so we'll do a G3, and you know what? We like those airstrikes, so we'll assign a G4 as well. Definitely want to try to attack across the canal again, so another G3 and a G4 there as well. Do we need any more units to reorganize? No, we don't. I think my OCD has got the most of the individual units in task forces. So let's see, we got 2 attacks there. What do we got over here? We got 3 units that really aren't next to anybody. So I could use three more G3s just to move guys up into position. You know, let's do that. We'll just make it simple. So we're going with five G3 markers and two G4 markers. All right, let's take a look at what the Germans got. Of course, the Germans are pretty much the same thing for the last couple three turns. But, again, I think my OCD is going to be kicking in and tidying up the battlefield a little bit. So let's take a G1. And I believe I had the 70th here. I think they have, I think they've still got one slot that they can put a unit into. Oh, if I could read. Yeah, I do. Okay. I gotta lean in real close to be able to see who's what task forces are labeled on there. Okay. So that's with the 70th right there. And then we have, whoops, I put the wrong unit on there. 3, 4, 3. No, I didn't. Yeah, okay. So they're there. And we have a coastal battery that's in that hex. Is that there? Oh no, 1039th was down there. All right, so, okay, we got that straight. And I believe over here, I think it was the 711th or the 245th. Let's take a look. 711th is full. They've got their maximum number of support units they can have in it. So the 245th. Oh, that was the 245th, 711th. They've got their maximum number of units. What about the 85th here? I think I could have swore I had two units. 85th has got four units in it. All right, so I guess maybe not. All right, well, then we're going to go ahead and burn a couple G1s for reinforcements and replacements. Let's see, where do we want to do this? Well, you know what? It's 711th has got one guy in it that's down two. So we'll do that. Three, which will get two. Yay, he's back up to full. And where's the 346th? 346th, where are you hiding? I know you're around here somewhere. Oh, there he is right there, 346. Let's take a look at the 712th. Yeah, we better do the 712th. They've got two units that are down two, so let's go with... they're both infantry, so let's go with that one. Five, gets three back. Yes, that's good. And we've got a G4 logistics marker, which really didn't do us any good. And, I don't think I really want to move anybody. I don't think I want to do a strategic move with anybody. I think everybody's good. All right, so, well, that G4 got wasted. All right, now, that's going to be turn four next turn. And, you know, I hate to do it. Well, let's go with the G1s across the board. Just to try to get more reinforcements, more troops in. And let's go with the G4 so we can call artillery in if we get attacked anywhere where there is viable artillery strikes. All right. Now, let's go ahead, jump into turn four. Now, on this turn, let's see, we got British 51st. I could bring the British 51st on. And all their subunits, which is, let's see if I can zoom in on them. I can't remember how to manipulate the camera. There's the 51st right there. So, you know, three infantry and one artillery brigade each. I can bring them on, but doing so, let's check the rules real quick. Historically, this unit was part of 1st British Corps, which formed part of the 1st Canadian Army. It did not directly take part in the Battle of the Scheldt, as it was covering a sector of the map to the east in the area not covered by the map. However, it could have been used, given offensive additional power while putting the Allied forces disadvantage elsewhere. Let's see. I could use them to bring them on. However, the German player gets one half a victory point for each turn. The 51st or any part of it is on the map. And to limit these gains, the Allied player may withdraw the division during any subsequent Allied preparation phase. And it has the option of coming in either Antwerp, which is right there, or Turnhout, right there. I don't think I need them over here. I mean, we saw what the 49th was able to do to the poor German task force. Kind of blew them up really good. So I don't think we need to bring on any additional firepower over here. So we're just gonna. Should not be yawning. All right. So we're just gonna jump into turn 4. Start of the Allies. Bunch of G3 markers. Couple G4 markers. All right. I think we were gonna use 1, 2. You know, it was 10 minutes ago, and I don't even remember what I was going to use them on. Three of the G3 markers we were going to use up here to move task forces into position. So let's go ahead and move the 1st Canadian to there. Let's move the 49th into the woods there. And the 2nd is going to advance into there. Now, if I want them to attack, I'm going to have to spend another G3 marker, but I'm not interested in attacking with them this turn. I've already got plenty of fun over here that I need to deal with, so we're going to use a G3 marker for the 4th to attack across the canal again. And let's use a G4 logistics marker to give us an airstrike, which is going to give us 3 bonus dice. So set the dice to the side. So we got the 4th. There's the 4th at. There's the 4th. Okay. 4th against the lone German infantry brigade. Now, let's just go ahead and count up. The Germans will get 4. I could burn a logistics counter. The Germans have got a G4 logistics counter, and let's see what artillery I could bring in. The battle's happening right here. I could bring in, that's got a range of 2, so I could bring in that artillery, because it's got a range of 5, that's got a range of 5. I could bring in 5 more dice, but I think I want to save that for the coming attack that the 3rd is going to be doing. So we're not going to be using the G4 for that, so... The Germans have only got 4, minus 1 for step loss is 3. And we got 2 hits. That's not good. Because the Canadians have only 1 unit that can take hits. All right. So let's take a look at what all the numbers are going to be for the German defense. Okay, it's going to be... crossing the canal, which is going to be plus 2. Village is going to be 3. Fortress is going to be 4. Polder is going to be 6. So the Germans have got a defense resistance of 6. Minus 1 because of the engineers that are attached, so they got a defense of 5. So we just need to remember... the Germans have got a defense resistance of 5. And let's go ahead and count up. Let's see, they've got 2 from their motorized infantry and 6 more from the artillery and 3 from the airstrike. Let's see, what do we end up with? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. Not enough to get over the German resistance. All right, so they inflict no casualties, whereas the Germans actually ended up doing 2 hits to the 10th Motorized. That is not good. So, return these guys to their sheet. And return the German to the hex he was defending. We got G3, one single G3 and G4 marker left. Camera's getting ready to cut out, so let me go ahead and cut it out and restart right back. All right, so we've got the G3 marker, final G3 marker. We're going to throw that. And the G4 for an airstrike. So that'll be 3 dice. And the third is going to be attacking the 64th. The Germans are going to burn their G4 marker to call in all local artillery. So this is going to be a big one. Let's see what we've got here. That's the second. This is the third. This may not go well. Well, they've got some... Canadians got some beefy units there. And the Germans is the 64th. Okay, so they've got everybody they've got is fresh, but they're all ad hoc units and an artillery unit. So you got ad hoc battalion, RHU. What the hell is RHU? I think that's a supply. Replacement holding unit. Yep. And some Kriegsmarine and motorized artillery. Alrighty, so the Germans will throw first, but let's take a look since we got the G4 that we threw in there. Everything that can, all artillery that can range in on that is going to be that unit right there. So that's 3, 4. That's out of range. 5. I think that's all the artillery. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, that's out of range. That's out of range. So, 3, 4, 5. So they get 5 artillery. And then just a grand total of 3 other dice. 1, 2, 3. So Germans have actually got a little bit of kick in them right here. Only because they've got all the artillery. So let's see, and let's see what defensive. They're in a village, so I believe the village gave them a defense resistance of 1. Village, defense resistance 1. So we'll just mark that there as defense resistance. And technically, the Canadians are attacking out of a polder, but they're following a road, so their motorized and mechanized elements will be able to assist in the combat. Ooh, big dice roll. Big, big dice roll. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 hits. Oh my god. Wow, that's gonna hurt. Oh, that's gonna crush the Canadians. Oops. That one can't have a hit on it because that would kill the artillery unit. So we're going to have to put a second hit somewhere else. All right. Wow, 8 hits. Well, we're going to have to put 5 on this one to make it a 6. And we can only put 3 on that one. So that's going to be a 5. And we can't put any artillery because that'll kill it. We don't want to kill the artillery. So, return attacks. These guys aren't going to get any dice because they're at -6 and their attack is a 6. He's going to get 2 dice. So there's 2 dice from that, 3 dice from the artillery, and 3 dice from the airstrike. So even though the Germans put a hell of a hurt on the British or the Canadians... Canadians can still muster some decent firepower. And what do we have? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 hits. -1 for the damage resistance is a 5. round half of it up for retreat is going to be a 3. So he needs to take 2 casualties. Well, crap. Let's go ahead and put 1 casualty on the Kriegsmarine, 1 casualty on the artillery. And they are going to have to retreat 3 hexes. So let's go 1, 2. Crap. You need a tactical move to move across there. Let's see what it says about retreats. What does it say about retreats? Okay, defending units may only retreat through hexes that are not in an uncontested enemy occupation operation zone and they may legally traverse in tactical movement. Isolated units may not retreat at all. Units may not retreat across prohibited terrain. Any motorized units may not retreat across unroaded, pulled, or flooded. Units may not retreat off the map. So, as written, the 64th can go 1, 2, 3, I believe. I mean, because as written, that's 1, 2, 3. And that means that the 3rd will be able to advance in. And probably going to start having a lot of fun with those coastal battery units. That's not good. That's not good at all. But the Germans did put a real nasty hurt on. They're probably going to have to sit down a couple turns and try to reorganize and get some replacements, because they took some bloody, bloody casualties. I think the only saving grace is the Germans don't have much offensive oomph in them, especially on this side of the estuary. So hopefully we won't be seeing very many attacks, although I have a feeling these guys may come back and try to strike at them. We'll see. All right, so that's it for the Canadians. So, yeah, well, first off, let's go ahead and choose our admin markers. Let's see, we're going to go 2 to replace those poor Canadians. I just got the crap kicked out of them. Let's go ahead and use a G4 marker for their defense in case they get attacked. They can have some air cover ahead up above. I think I'm going to kind of have to put the attack here on hold. Now, you know what? Let's go ahead, do a G3 so we can move this unit up and kind of start threatening the Germans. Oops, you can't see that. To move this guy up and start threatening the Germans' flanks over here. And over here, we got 3 task forces that are in position. So let's go ahead and just do 3 more G3 markers for attacks. So that's what we're going to do. Now for the German side of the turn, they're down to 3 markers because they spent their G4 for the artillery defense strike. G1s. You know what? Ah, crap. See, I didn't know that the 64th was going to end up retreating so far. I'd have put a G3 in there so I can move. But you know what? We're going to use 2 of those G1s to reinforce or replace 2 of the units in the 64th, left to right, 4 and 6, so 2 and 3. So basically, is that the right unit? You know what? That's the wrong unit. I was thinking it was this unit. It's this unit. So they actually get back. And then I got another G1 marker. Where's the 86th? Is that the 86th? It's 95th. 85th. 85th is going to be getting hit by the Poles here soon. Yeah, let's do the 85th. Let's get one replace, well, one point, of course. All right, so now, what do the Germans want to do now? Let's take two admin markers, two G1s. Let's go with a G3, because we need to get the 64th back over into position. We need to have him move back over, because we cannot have the third just rampaging blindly across my artillery there. And let's go with a G4. Excuse me again. Just because we like that artillery. That artillery was nice and tasty last time. So, all right, there we go. And, oh, you know what? Germans have got reinforcements coming on. I'm probably going to have to spend those G1 markers to bring them on and form them into a task force. Yeah. All right. So, too much need to do, not enough command markers. All right. So that's all I got. Turns 3 and 4. And I do want to warn everybody right now, you may not be seeing much out of the original Grognard after Tuesday, because that's when Mass Effect Andromeda releases, and I am going to get lost in that game for a while. So I apologize that I'm not going to be around probably very much for a week or two or maybe three. Questions, comments, concerns, complaints, criticisms in the comment section. I'll talk to everybody later. See ya!